this afternoon from Polarean Imaging is Richard Hullihen. Richard, nice to see you.
Good to see you again, Andrew.
Well, good to get an update. Recently, a couple of weeks back, I think you had the pre-NDA meeting with the FDA. How did that go?
We did. That was a big milestone for us. So if you remember, the backstory here is always good to square up before you head into a submission, because by that point in time, you would have been in a dialogue with the FDA for a couple of years, you know, with emails back and forth, people asking questions and those kinds of things. So always a good idea to call for the meeting. It's elective, but call for the meeting, square all that up, ask all those questions, document all the answers, have those things all captured in the minutes for the meeting, and then no surprises when you make the submission. So we did go through that. The meeting went pretty much as we expected. The minutes kind of confirmed that. So we're now full on into the submission, which is coming up here shortly.
So you're looking to submit, I think you've said Q3.
Yep. The information we've had in front of the public for a while has been Q3. One of the big reasons to have that meeting is to make sure you're still on track in the timing sense for that. Nothing coming out of the meeting changed our opinion about that. So full on for Q3 submission right now.
And following that submission, what's the rough time frame that you'd be expecting to hear back?
Yeah, good question. So we're, of course, a drug device combination being managed by the drug side of the house at the FDA, CDER, as they're known. So for a drug, the kind of statutory review period is 10 months. And if you remember our backstory here, we're also seeking the regulatory grant of market exclusivity in the US, known as Hatch-Waxman protection. Is another 2 months. So all in from submission, 12 months to approval. And that's also kind of consistent with our story out there.
And all this, of course, Richard, this comes on the back of the positive data from the two phase three trials, which I think you snuck in right at the end of last year.
We did. We got those. And the top line readout was good. Very happy about that. If you remember our story, this was a head-to-head equivalence trial versus a comparator. So it's unambiguous. You either did or you didn't. And so we did. Very happy about that. And of course, the FDA's charter here is kind of safety and efficacy. So check, efficacy done. In this submission, we'll be making the rest of our data available on the safety side. Happily, the FDA is pretty comfortable with xenon. Inert noble gas comes and goes with breath. So pretty happy about that as well. So we like the situation here.
Are you still, in the meantime, are you making sales of the research units?
Yeah, we are. We are selling and installing equipment. Happily, research goes on. Science progresses. We have an active pipeline there. We'll be making a couple of announcements in that space. We did have one of our kind of colleagues be notified of their winning of the award, but we can't announce that until it's papered up. So in due course, we'll be announcing that, but we have an active pipeline, happy about that. Because our contract manufacturers are essential businesses in the US, we're able to continue building machines. So that's good, happy about that. And then a bunch of the rest of what we do with respect to the submission and those kinds of things has always been a Zoom-based activity. So not much difference from our point of view on that score.
Well, as you mentioned, your target customers, you've already identified. So essentially, you can go straight to market with this.
Yep. So if you remember, this is following the path of CT and MR to a great degree. We're an adjunct technology to MR. So this is kind of the best and brightest in medical imaging out there, combined with the best and brightest in pulmonary medicine. So we know where those folks are. It's entirely knowable. You can see every journal article that's ever been published by those folks. So I think we know where they are. So we'll be doing this directly post-approval, and they're well identified, and we are on. We have now actually begun our commercial launch prep. So that was the subject of the raise that we had in March. So we are now full on kind of commercial launch prep while we finish up the submission here.
Well, on the back of that launch, you're now sufficiently financed, are you?
Yeah, so that raise, you know, we have the characteristic, kind of have become known, doing this on a milestone basis. So that raise takes us literally to launch. Yep.
And you've appointed a new chairman this year, have you?
Yes. So if you remember, Jonathan Alice was actually on our board, kind of quietly there. Jonathan was actually also at GE Amersham at the same time that our founder was, and was actually associated with the hyperpolarized noble gas imaging project there. So he knows all about us, knows the technology and the people. He has now moved from being on the board to being our chairman. It's a great opportunity for us because, of course, he's just done this at Blue Earth, his former company. So he took a different compound out of the GE Amersham program. It happened to be a PET tracer, a PET imaging agent, just did exactly all of these things, launched that product, commercialized it, took it to market, and sold the company to Bracco last year for 450 million pounds. So yeah, great. Wonderful to have him. And it has certainly stepped up the game of the board here.
So last year, that was about proving up the technology. This year, it's getting the NDA submitted.
Yes. So this is now all about the submission. The whole point of this and the pre-meeting is you want to make the submission and have that simply go through the process. You don't want to be involved in questions and answers and those kinds of things, which take large quantities of time, particularly in this distributed environment. So yeah, that right now it's submission and commercial preparation.
And just remind us, how lucrative is the market that you're going after?
Yeah, well, that's the interesting thing. So if you remember the long game here, the long story is, when CT and MR were rolled out to medicine in a very kind of cruel twist of physics and physiology, pulmonary medicine was left behind. It was not revolutionized in the way that cardiology and oncology and musculoskeletal imaging were. So without us, there really wasn't much of an opportunity for pulmonary medicine to benefit from high resolution, three-dimensional quantitative imaging. So now with us comes this, but the consequence of not having the tool in the US is that the US healthcare delivery system burden for pulmonary medicine is on the order of some $150 billion a year trying to take care of all these patients. So we're excited to be bringing this tool and pulmonary medicine into the 21st century.
Great to see you, Richard. Thanks for the update.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate it.